Arriba está el Olympia President Mohamed Riaz, General Secretary and High Deputy, the State President and Secretary, eminent personalities on the stage, Angola, Sahodari Gale, Sahodara Gale, Vanaka. I'm very, very happy to be here amongst you to greet the public meeting on the occasion of the 16th State Conference of the Tamil Nadu DYFI. I was asking him whether he said, I'm very happy to be here. I have heard that last year or this year, the DYFI in Tamil Nadu has enrolled 8 lakh young men and women in the organization, thereby becoming the third largest state organization of the DYFI in India. And we are proud of you because we know the future of India, the future of the democratic movement in India, the future of the generations who come after us depends on this organization and their mobilization of young people. And I congratulate the state DYFI and wish it a bright future. My dear friends, just neighboring to this district of Shivagangai, we know that just a few weeks ago, the terrible cyclonic disaster of Gaja had hit a large number of families, a large number of people of this state. Even today, thousands of people are homeless. Even today, thousands of people are without any means of livelihood. And yet, my dear friends, after 3 weeks, it is shameful that the Modi government at the center and the state government of Tamil Nadu have utterly failed to bring relief to the people affected by the Gaja. Today we see EPS and OPS, they are playing a game of musical chairs and they are not at all bothered about bringing, you know what musical chairs is, no? That is Isai Narkali. Huh? You know this Isai Narkali, the children are playing, no? Move the chair, the music will go, the music will start. OPS, EPS, EPS, OPS. They are doing Isai Narkali and Modi ji is coming and occupying all the chairs, but the people of Tamil Nadu are getting no relief. Modi ji got all the chairs. Modi ji is expert at getting all the chairs. Now, we have heard from Riaz. You have a central minister here from Tamil Nadu. I don't know whether his name is Pon or Krishnan or Radha or Pon Radha Krishnan. But what we will say is, he is there in the ministry, utterly failed to bring any relief to the people of Tamil Nadu. He is more interested in going to Kerala. Of course, people of Kerala are very hospitable. He can always go there. But what we will suggest, Mr. Pon Radhakrishnan, please go to Kerala. 3 months ago, Kerala faced the worst floods in the last 100 years. And within 1 week, the entire relief camp network was set up and all the people who had been badly affected today for a new Kerala. Today, the Kerala government, the first priority is to bring relief to the people of Kerala. Mr. EPS, OPS, Mr. Pona Dalakrishnan, please go to Kerala and learn the word humanity, learn the word Janaseva, learn the word people service from those who are working in Kerala. Why am I raising these issues today? Because this is an example of what is happening to our country under the Modi government. This is an example of how the word people service is being totally removed from the political dictionary of our country. Look at what is happening in Meghalaya. My dear friends, today we have heard that the Cabinet of India has taken a decision that in 2022 they will put Indians in a space flight to the moon. Yes, we are very happy that our Indian scientists are so brilliant as far as space technology is concerned. The Cabinet can make a plan to send people to the moon, but the Cabinet of Modi government could not make any plan to save the 15 working miners who are stuck in a mine in Meghalaya, drowning to death. They could not save their lives. They could not use science and technology to save the lives of the workers there. But they can take a Catholic decision to send men to the moon. This is the culture of the Modi government. No humanity, no service for the people. That is their credo. And that is the difference. The first difference is organizations like the DYFI, who believe in left and progressive ideologies. Organizations like the DYFI are committed to service of the people. They are committed to public service of the people. And that is why we are proud that our culture of politics is totally different from the culture of greed, which is being promoted by the Modi government and the Sangh Parivar. My dear friends, we know that more than 60% of India's population is below the age of 40 years. And we know what is the plight of the youth of India. And our main slogan today, our question to the Modi government today, we have one question to Modi. Modiji, tell the youth, where are our jobs? Where are the jobs you promised us, Modi? Answer that question. We know the truth of Modi's claims. My dear friends, in March this year, the railways had advertised vacancies for 90,000 posts. And how many people applied for 90,000 posts? More than 2 crore young people applied for those posts. For class 4 posts, we had engineers, we had postgraduates applying for those posts. We had set 2 crore jobs every year. But my dear brothers and sisters, we know, forget about giving jobs. This is the period where the highest rate of unemployment is there among our youth. Today, the Modi government is following policies not just of jobless youth, but job loss youth. We know what happened after demonetization. That is demonetization. And Modi ji said many things. What will happen? All the black money will come back. All the terrorists will stop. Everything will become fine for India. And what happened? My dear friends, Modi established a world record. This is the one government which showed the world how in 1 point doing demonetization converted all the black money into white money, because according to the RBI, 99.9% of all the money which had been banned has come back into the banking system. Vare Vare Modi ji, what a wonderful magic wand you have. But even more than that, because of demonetization, 35 lakh jobs, 35 lakh livelihoods in the unorganized sector were lost. That is why we say not just jobless, but job loss growth. That is what Modi ji has given this country. And that is why the youth of India, the young people of India, all across the country have decided that Modi ji, 4.5 years, you gave us no jobs. In 2019, we are going to remove you from your chair in Delhi. We will ensure our struggles, our movement, our unity will bring a government which will have an alternative set of policies to bring the youth of India the jobs which they require. And my dear friends, when we talk about joblessness and joblessness, we must remember that here in Tamil Nadu, following the path of their leader in Delhi, here in Tamil Nadu, this government of EPS, OPS, they have refused to fill the government vacancies. They have refused to give proper jobs to the youth of Tamil Nadu. And whatever jobs are being given are outsourced jobs with no wages, with no benefits. That is what the Tamil Nadu government is doing. So Modi cannot give jobs, but Modi can manufacture lies. The only factory working under Modi government is the factory of manufacturing of lies. And we know what that means, because he has lied about the election promises. He has betrayed the promises made to the people of India, to the youth of India. And therefore now, my dear friends, the Modi government, led by the RSS, is trying to divide India on the basis of sectarian, divisive politics. Today, the RSS is working overtime with all the organizations of the Sangh Parivar, once again bringing up the divisive politics of the Ram Temple. That is what, when they fail in electoral promises, they are bringing up the issue of the Ram Temple. And what they are doing is trying to organize and mobilize the youth of India. My dear brothers and sisters, the DYFI has a very big challenge it is facing, confronted by these forces of darkness of the RSS and the Sangh Parivar. They are promoting an ideology, they are promoting a culture, they are promoting practices which go against every single important value which we learned from the freedom struggle. The very constitution of India every day is being challenged by the RSS and the BJP and the Sangh Parivar at every level of society. And the driving force is the ideology of Manavar. See what is happening to Dalit youth. They protested against the Supreme Court judgment diluting the SCST Prevention of Atrocities Act. And instead of supporting them, what did the Modi government and the BJP governments do? They threw them into jail. Even today, scores of young Dalits are in the jails in Madhya Pradesh, in Rajasthan, in many other states. So our demand of the newly elected Congress governments in these states is, make a difference, release the Dalit youth, take back all the cases against them. That is what our demand today. More than 40,000 women are raped every year in this country. That is what the latest figures show. And what is most shocking, that of these rapes, there is an 82% increase in the rapes of minors, in the rapes of children of India. And yet these shameless leaders of the Bharatiya Janata Party, in state after state, chief minister after chief minister, MP after MP, they make one statement, and that statement is to blame women for the atrocities against them. They say, what is the dress you are wearing? They ask, why are you going out in the evening? They blame the women for the crimes against them. This is the greatest shame of India, that in our politics today, you have political leaders who blame women for the crimes which are committed against them. My dear friends, here in Tamil Nadu, you have a history, a legacy of social reform. Here you have those who have challenged Manumar. It is part of your cultural history. It is part of your cultural activism and intervention. The entire Dravidian philosophy was supposed to be based on social reform and the challenge to the caste system, the challenge to patriarchy. But today, I would like to ask those who are or who claim to be the inheritors of this anti-Manavadi, rationalist, scientific philosophy. I ask them today, where is your commitment to social reform? Today in Tamil Nadu, when honor killings are taking place, when young Dalit boys and young girls from the so-called upper class are in a relationship, they are being lynched, they are being killed. Today, where are the voices? We are proud that the DYFI, we are proud that the red flag in Tamil Nadu has stood against so-called honor killings. But we ask the leaders of the Dravidian movement, where are you? Why are you silent? Where is the legacy of social reform? But we say today, even if they are silent, we will never be silent against this injustice, against this retrograde ideologies and practices. My friend Shashikala, she is our Madhura Labour Secretary. I was asking her, what are the popular TV series here? She told me about one called Simbalati. About that woman, a domestic worker in a very rich house, and how she is tortured, how she is repressed, and yet she has so much patience. There are many Sembalatis who are tortured. There are many Sembalatis who are patient. But today, from this platform, I ask the DYFI, I ask all you young men and women, stand up and give voice to the Sembalatis so they can stand up and never accept the torture that this patriarchal capitalist society gives them. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, the days ahead are challenging, but the DYFI and your movement is not afraid of challenges. Many of you have the picture of Bhagat Singh on your vest. Bhagat Singh is immortal. Why is that so? At the young age of 23, he gave up the most precious gift, his own life, so that India could live, so that India could be free, so that India's youth would have the right to dream, and through that dream, to build a new India. Bhagat Singh was 716 days in the British jail, and his biographers say He read 300 books in that time. So he knew how to study. He knew how to learn. He knew the importance of knowledge, and he knew the importance of using that knowledge for the betterment of the country, for the betterment of its future. So today we need to learn from that spirit. When we give the slogan Inqilab Zindabad, we know that that slogan was first given by the young and brilliant Bhagat Singh. And therefore, while understanding, identifying and accepting the challenges, we here today must pledge we will take forward the legacy of service to the people. We will take forward the legacy of social reform. We will take forward the legacy against Manubadi practices and ideologies. And together, we will unite the youth and the people of India in the coming days to defeat the forces of darkness and bring India into a brighter day, a brighter light, and wish the sun will shine on all the lives of the youth of India. I thank you very much, and I extend my warm greetings to all of you and my very best wishes for the success of the 16th State Conference of the DYFI Inqilab Zindabad, DYFI Zindabad.